I am teaching a couple of journalism and political science courses this semester, and I've asked those students for questions. One of those students is Ben Tompkins, who is a senior journalism major from Prospect, Kentucky. And his question was, and they've really been eager to learn. They've soaked it up like a sponge, everything that we've tried to impart to them. Al Cross is the my co-instructor, the lead instructor. But his question, Ben's question is, how would you respond to voters that claim they don't know enough about you and that you have let Senator McConnell's campaign define you through ads?
Well, first, I would say our democracy isn't up for sale. We each have a role to play, and despite Senator McConnell pushing unlimited funds in campaigns, the spending that's been done, over $51 million in negative, nasty, untrue ads against me, we haven't blinked. I haven't backed up. Neither have the people of Kentucky, because they know what my record is. They also realize this election isn't up for sale. They won't be bought. They're ready for someone that will finally put them first, as I have in the office of Secretary of State. My record speaks for itself. It is one of being an independent thinker, able to put the partisanship aside and reach out across the aisle. You don't pass historic legislation here in this state, our military heroes voting bill, a bill that's never been passed before, actually started in the Republican-controlled Senate, unless you're able to reach out and form the coalitions that are necessary to make sure that Kentuckians' lives are better. That's what public service is all about. That's what Washington is missing. And as we have traveled this state, I know the struggles that the people of Kentucky are enduring right now. I know down in the Bend, Miss Daisy Wilson, who is nearing 90 years old, in the 30 years that Mitch McConnell's been in Washington, she's never seen our senator once. Or in Henderson, the struggles that they're going through right now to actually increase manufacturing, because we don't have a senator that wants to keep jobs here, but rather give tax breaks and trade deals that outsource good Kentucky jobs. Or go to Mammoth Cave, where they felt the impact of the sequester cuts. These are the struggles of Kentuckians that I know. That's the reason why, as we travel from the western part of the state to the eastern part of the state to northern Kentucky, the momentum and energy enthusiasm, it's palpable. We don't have to pay for that enthusiasm. They're there because they know my record, despite the millions of dollars that have been spent against us.
And you feel like that message and people getting to know you has come through?
I do. There are obviously huge demands on the time, and this is a statewide campaign. If there's one thing I wish there were more of, it's more hours in the day, because getting to know Daisy Wilson in the Bend, or go all the way over to Harlan, where I zip-lined down Black Mountain with Magistrate David Kennedy and got to understand how we haven't had a senator who's understood the struggles of Eastern Kentucky, fought for them to be able to have increased investment in infrastructure and tourism, or Northern Kentucky, how they felt like they've been a political football going back and forth as the Brent Spence Bridge project languished, and ready for someone that will fight for the funding necessary for this vital infrastructure project, not on the backs of Kentuckians in the form of tolls. They know who I am. Kentuckians, most importantly, know what I'm about. They know that the jobs plan that we have put forth, it was developed with them in mind, making sure that we give hardworking Kentuckians a way back into the middle class, that we strengthen our foundation and give all Kentuckians an opportunity for shared prosperity.
The other class and the other university I'm associated with is Campbellsville University. Mm-hmm. The students in that class asked me to ask you, and they wrote it out this way, the millennial generation is concerned about their future. In fact, they may be the first generation who will have a lower standard of living and earn less in income than their parents. What can you say to them, and what have you said to the millennials on the campaign trail that can give them some hope for their future?
Well, I think their concerns are very valid, because what we have now isn't working for Kentucky, from our seniors down to our students. We have to have someone who believes, as I do, that this isn't the lost generation. In the era of texting and tweeting and chatting, Pundits bet against them. They said they wouldn't show up in the prior election. I didn't take that bet. I bet on them, and they actually increased their turnout by 1%. I bet on them in this election. They show up, and they'll have a senator who knows the struggles that they are going through, believes that we should have someone backing our students, giving them the ability to actually afford to go to college, earn degrees, not debt, instead of one that has turned his back and chosen to back Wall Street instead of our students. I know the struggles that Kentucky students are going through. We have 360,000 students carrying $20,000 on average of student loan debt. That's horrible. It's wrong. It is a sign and a signal that Washington isn't working, especially for the future of this state. Education, it is the passport into the middle class. And I believe that our students, our recent graduates, they shouldn't be struggling to be a part of especially a bright future of Kentucky and of this nation because they have student loan debt higher than their mortgage. I've sat down and had these conversations in Boyle County with the recent graduates that have gotten that great degree. They have got good paying jobs, but they can't make the investment in the house that they want to buy for their growing family because they've got student loan payments higher than their mortgage. Mm-hmm. We can address this, but it requires a senator that has the jobs plan that does specifically address making sure we're training our workers for the jobs of today, not just for today, but for tomorrow, and that we are giving our students equal footing, especially to bring a bright future to Kentucky.